Hello, high levelers, Rayo Daniel here. And in this video, we're going to go over some of the new calendar features and the calendar types that the Go High Level platform has just come out with, and go over some of the basic usage and show you a few of them and what they look like. So this video is not going to be very long. It's just meant to give people, especially people who are just starting out the Go High Level platform, really just a good base information about what type of calendars are available, how you can get them set up and things like that. Let's hop into it. Okay, here we are inside of one of our demo accounts, and over on the left-hand menu, we're going to go into the calendar section. And here in the calendar section, we're going to come up here to the calendar settings. This is an account. I've got several different type of calendars here configured, but right now what I want to do is first of all, just start out with just the interface itself. Notice that there is, we're going to start up here to the top right. Notice we have a create group. I'm going to go over groups here in just a little bit. Not right now. We got just a create calendar, and I'm going to show you what that looks like. We've got all of our calendars listed. If you want to, we've got all of our groups, different kind of groups that we can have. Again, I'll look over that. You do have a service menu, so the different type of services that you can offer in your calendars. You also have the ability to book rooms and book equipment. So this is really a big thing for people who's having a resource problem here. And I'm actually gonna, again, go over that here, one of the examples I've got in when I'm talking about the groups. But you can also book rooms inside of your calendar to show that those rooms are not available on the calendar for certain times, and equipment. Because sometimes people, I'm gonna use an example of a photo shoot. Sometimes people have different rooms booked and different cameras and equipment and props and things like that for a photo shoot that now you can keep track of inside of the high level calendar, just to make sure that you know that they're not available because somebody already has them booked. So right now, what I wanna do is come up here and just click on the create calendar. And right now what you're gonna get is we're gonna get a couple of different calendar types here. Now, I'm gonna blow this up just a little bit here just to make them easier to view. Right now we've got, as you can see, six different kinds of calendars here, and they're really made for specific purposes. And the high level system has really grown to add these different type of calendars for all the different requests that the Go High Level users have been requesting the calendars be used for. Now, the very basic one here is the personal booking calendar. So this one right here, if you look at the personal booking calendar, this one is for just individual one-on-one. If you think of the Calendly software or things like that, just simply a personal calendar to book any of your personal appointments on. It could be Zoom calls, strategy calls, something like that. Then you've got those. So that's what the personal booking, and it's been renamed, but that type of calendar has always been available inside of high level. Another one that we have is the round robin. This is really when you start having a sales team. So let's just say if you have a booking for a calendar, and you've got, let's just say you can have one slot or one time period inside of your calendar, but it's available for multiple different people. Now, what I mean by this is that round robin is really just an example would be a sales team. So let's just say you have 10 salespeople that are all working, let's just say 9 to 5 every day. And let's just say at 1 p.m. in the afternoon, somebody can book a 1 o'clock appointment. And then that appointment will go to the next person that is in the user list that you assign. And again, inside of this calendar, you can add all the team members for this particular calendar. And we'll take a look at some of the settings here again a little bit later on. But the round robin is really just you can add as many team members as you want. And then each appointment time becomes available to each team member. So if you have 10 team members, and each team member's user availability inside there is from 9 to 5. Then at 1 o'clock, you can have 10 people book the 1 o'clock slot because you have 10 team members that it will cycle through before that slot no longer becomes available to any of the team members because it's already booked. Okay. So that's typically the kind of calendar that you can have for a round robin type of calendar. Here's one I know that people were looking for a lot, and that is a class booking. What if you want to actually have an online class or a physical class, whatever that is, but how can I book and only allow a certain amount of people inside of this particular event? Now, I'm going to show you a live example of this one here because I think it's pretty cool of how you can actually do that. But this is where you can actually book a class. You can specify how many people need to be in there so that people can book for that particular time period. But then once that the number of seats have been filled for that class, you can no longer book anymore, and then they have to go to the next time period slot. So that's a pretty cool calendar feature as well. The collective booking, this is where you can have multiple hosts meet with one participant. So if you ever do like online interviews, job interviewing, things like that, this is really good where you can have multiple hosts log in and actually have one person on the calendar. So this is where you can actually book a session and actually book multiple team members on your side to be put onto one event. Instead of like the round robin we talked about where it was one salesperson per one call, now you've got multiple people that can be booked for one participant. So again, if you're looking for that kind of calendar, we're not going to go over it, but it's here in case you want to use it. But here for the next one here is the event calendar. This is a big one because this is one, like what happens if you want to have just a showing or an event or something like that? It's not a class, but it's actually just an event that you can have. This right here, public seminars, as you see, this is a great calendar for this one. And then your service booking. So this is really great if you, if your whole goal for the calendar is to book appointments, whether it be for your services, things like that. So this is great if you have a service-based business, HVAC, plumbing, those kind of home services. This service booking is exactly made for putting it on their particular website and book service bookings. Okay. So these are the kinds of calendars that you can create. Now I've already created some of them here. And one of the things I want to do is hop in and take a quick look here. Not sure why it's freezing up on me here. So here we're going to come up here and just take a look at this. Again, I've got my very first one here, this MacBook training. So if you come in here and just take a look, once we edit this thing, we can edit it. Notice you can actually have a logo here, give it a title, to give it a description, a group, things like that. You can even have your selected team member who's going to be responsible for this kind of thing here and give them all a tag. The availability, you can just simply put in what the availability of the classrooms are and all the reoccurring meetings. And these are just standard calendar features that you can put in there, how long it's going to be, the meeting duration, but things like that, and the time between different classes, stuff like that. You can even have payments if you want to. So you can include one of the calendar features is include, as soon as they schedule it, you can actually request a payment for that. And that really comes in well for a class. So if they want to book a class, they can book it and actually pay for it right then at the time. If not, then they can move on. But right now, notice that down here at the bottom, our accept payments is off. But if we wanted to, we can say accept payments. We can charge a total amount and things like that if we wanted to. So that's pretty nice. All the notifications. So this is where in Highlevel, when somebody books an appointment here, all the statuses, the emails go out about booking appointment, and each calendar booking appointment gives you the ability to save it to your calendar. If you're the subscriber, if you're the person that's scheduling here, it'll actually send you a link and actually give you a rescheduling and canceling link inside of it as well. So that's pretty nice. And again, all of the calendar features now have this new customization, and I'm going to show you what that looks like here. So you can come and customize the particular calendar, choose colors and things like that inside of here as well. So this right here is just some of the features that you could have. Now, the next thing I want to go over, and I remember talking about groups. Grouping is a great way if you have a service-based business. And again, in this kind of case, I'm going to use the photo shoot example that I used earlier. What happens if you want to do a photo shoot, but you've got multiple photographers? How do you sit back and book multiple photographers for each particular kind of service? This is where you actually start including groups. So you group those services together, and then inside of the groups, you simply add the different technicians or the photographers, whatever you want to call it, to that particular meeting group. And then you'll actually see, once you put them in a group, then you can actually see how this looks when you display the calendar on a particular website. So right now, what I want to do is just give you a quick overview of what this looks like. And let's hop into the, this is the MacBook training one. So here in this example, this is a cool image slider feature that Highlevel has on their site. But this right here is how you can kind of book for a calendar. Notice that we have this calendar. I choose a customization of red, and I've got that nice little MacBook logo here on the top. So it actually gives you the duration. Somebody can come in here and choose any particular slot they want. And notice here, if we take a look, we've got each section, and we notice that we've got the number of seats available. So right now we've got 10 seats that are available per class. That could be the maximum amount of people. And it doesn't have to be physical. This could be all over Zoom call and stuff like that if you want to as well. It could, again, could be virtual, but you select this, and depending upon the time, then you would go down and select one more. So if I did this and selected this, I can come in here and put in my information. So give me a second here. I'm just testing this. Now, this confirmation, this is a nice one here, because if you ever want people to get text messages and emails, then you want to make sure that you get their consent to contact them. So this right here is what that is. And you can sit back and just say book appointment. Now, at this point, you know, all that information goes out, and you can actually see how you can add this to your calendar here. So it goes to Google, Outlook, and even the iCloud calendar, and everything gets booked. Now, let's just say we want to go back and launch this page again. So let's go back and remove this. So once we do this, if we come back up in here, I was just trying to, if I scroll here to this one, notice that this right here, blow this up. Notice that the session that we booked, now we only have 9 seats available. That right there is just a way of how people book. You can make sure that there's only a certain amount of people that actually can join that session to make sure it doesn't get overpacked or a physical classroom, because you may only have a certain number of seats in that classroom. So again, this is pretty cool. And all of the features that you would normally get for a calendar are included. Now, again, there is code that you can put. This comes natively on the Go High Level website. But if you do have a third party for this one, all you have to do is come here, click on these little things and click share. And inside of here, when you get this, you can have different links. So if you wanted to, you can just copy this link and send a link out in an email if you want to. If you're sending out an email blast for people to schedule a link, they can just simply copy this and go directly to it if they wanted to. Or if you wanted to, you can actually come here to the embed code. And forgive me, this embed code here. This is where you can copy this code and actually put it on a different website other than Highlevel's. So you can put this on a WordPress, you know, and any other site that allows you to put like a custom code on the page. So again, you can share that out and actually have this calendar. I'm not sure why this is freaking out, but you can actually have this calendar booking right here on a third party website. So again, that's pretty cool that you can sit back and do that. And the calendars that flexible to be able to do that. So this is just one of the things. Finally, I just want to show you about the booking appointment. This is just a template. I just built this just to show you, but the book appointment. So if you want to book an appointment, and again, this would be like for a photo shoot. So here for photo shoots, now you would just simply say, okay, let's just say you want to do a newborn session. You got your little baby or even a headshot, but let's just say a newborn session. These sessions are going to be 30 minutes, but this is how the group looks. So now you don't have to have a particular break the services out. You can just say, okay, choose the type or the group. And guess what the grouping is? The type of service that you want. The new board session. Okay, I want this session. Great. Now that you've selected that session, now you can say, here's the staff that's available. Now, this is the great thing. Once you configure, your staff has availability on a user level of when they're working and when they're not working. So if this time doesn't match what the user availability is, then the person just simply won't show up. Highlevel is easy enough to say, hey, John's not available for this particular session. But right now you can simply click John or Jane. Let's just say, oh, I want Jane. So now once we do this, now it goes into the newborn session calendar. And notice that Jane Smith is already the one who's been selected. And now the people can come through and book whatever session they want for this date, this time with Jane Smith for the newborn session. So again, very straightforward, very easy to get configured. Guys, I hope this was a great, just a little overview of the Go High Level calendars, of how, what they can do and how they can be created. Again, you can get very creative on this for the different type of calendars that we have. But guys, just real quick, if you learned a few things in this session, hit the like button, leave me a comment. I appreciate it. If you have not subscribed to my channel, hit the subscribe button. I give a lot of great content and information here. And guys, thanks so much for visiting with me today and have a great day. Bye-bye.